Good day. Today I'll show you a spreadsheet program you can use to check a column section. This spreadsheet program was designed by the Reinforced Concrete Council, and you can quickly use it to determine if a column section is adequate for an already calculated column load and moment. So here is what the spreadsheet program looks like, and the values in the blue color cells can actually be changed, and that is what you change to determine if the column section is adequate or not. So looking at the spreadsheet program, we can see there is a place where you can change the values of the materials, values of strength of concrete, strength of steel, and factors of safeties. Here we, under the section column, we can change the section to the type we want to see, to check or see if it's adequate or not. Under reinforcement, we can also change the values of for reinforcement. And the output is actually the graph here. Now, the area bounded by the tick, this tick red line here, if the column section is adequate, these two dots here will be within the area bounded by this tick red line, and the closer the points are to the top of this line or to the edge of this line, the more economical that section is. So the default section here was 450 by 300, and it was reinforced with two Y25 bars and 3Y32 bars. We could see the diagram here. So now let's say I want to check if a 225 column section that's reinforced with 4Y16 bars, is it adequate to maybe carry a load of 1000 kilonewtons and subjected to a moment of 20 kilonewtons per meter? Let's try it out just as an example. So first of all, I go to the load cases. And before I continue, mind you, these two dots represent each of the load cases. Now, you may use two load cases, you may use one load. In this case, I just want to use one load case. So I will change this first load case to 1000. And a moment, I just want to, and the moment's to 20. Then I do the same for this one. So notice now that because we have the two load cases here, they are the same, the dot overlap, and we could see from here that if we are to use that column section, it very well takes care of these loads. You can see the dot here, but we can make it more economical, and so we now have to manipulate other values as well. I could change this strength of concrete to say 25, and I could change the strength of steel to 4110. I could also change the section. I want to try 225 by 225 section, so I change it. And here you see how the diagram is changing to conform with the values I inputted in the blue cells. And so I go to the reinforcements. I want Y16, both for the top and bottom, 2Y16, top 2Y16, bottom. So and there it is. Now you see from the graph there that this section is not adequate because this dot here is outside, you know, this graph, outside the area bounded by the red line. So what we can do, we can actually increase the reinforcement, or we can increase the section. Let's first increase the reinforcement. Let's see whether 2Y20 bars can work. Y20 bar still doesn't work. So let's change the section. Let's try to change one of the sides. Let's say we change it from 225 to 300. And let's see what happens. Now the section is adequate now because the dot just falls below this thick red line here. So this is an easy way to determine if a section is adequate. or what kind of section will be adequate to carry a pre-calculated column load and moment. It's very handy, very useful, even for size condition, to quickly check or to quickly design, you know, a column section that will work. So thanks for watching. If you like this spreadsheet program, I've provided a link to download it, and you can find it in the description that comes with this video. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.